Welcome to NASA Edge, an inside and outside look at all things NASA. Joining us today is a longtime friend of the show, Michelle Monk. Thanks for coming on the show, Michelle.
Thanks for having me, Blair.
Now, when we've talked before, you've shared your expertise in the entry, descent, and landing process that we study when we send spacecrafts to other planets. But now you're working on a particular part of EDL, landing. Can you tell us what you're working on now?
Yes, Blair, it's really exciting. We have a payload called SCALPS, which is the stereo cameras for lunar plume surface studies. And we're studying just the touchdown of the lander and how big of a crater will be dug as a small robotic lander lands on the moon in 21. You know, we have the historic footage from Apollo where we had cameras looking out the window of the capsule, showing us what Neil and Buzz saw as they approached the surface and how their view was obscured by the regolith that was being kicked up and shot outward. But we don't have any view, particularly right under the lander. So what we're trying to do with SCALPS is see that crater as it's formed and get a very pristine view of it. We will have a view of some of the lander leg portions. We'll also be able to see after landing how any dust that remains hovering around the lander will settle down, say on the foot pads. Apollo looked at Surveyor and saw a sandblasting effect. And so that forms the basis for the knowledge that we have that particles go quite far and with quite high energy. And that's one of the things we want to investigate in the future.
You know, if regolith is spreading out, you now have to think with all that we're planning on doing on the moon, you know, how that might impact other landers or other equipment that we already have functioning on the lunar surface.
Yes, actually the landing event is one of the biggest producers of dust. So we're an important input to that whole mitigation strategy.
So now I'm also wondering, you said that you were going to go on a remote lander. So what is this remote lander and how did you get SCALPS attached to this lander?
Yeah, it's a really good question, Blair. We're going on one of the first two CLPS landers, and CLPS is the Commercial Lunar Payload Services. And the idea there is that NASA pays to have their packages sent to the moon, but NASA does not pay to build the truck. And so commercial companies have private investors who have funded the development and the building of small robotic landers. And we are buying space on those landers to send our scientific and engineering instruments.
It seems like that this has more far-reaching implications as well. What is the trajectory of SCALPS moving forward as we continue to explore our solar system?
Well, really the goal with SCALPS is to provide some flight data to improve and anchor our models. So if we can get some data returned from an actual flight at the moon and then be able to predict that in our computational models, then we can to some degree extrapolate to other landers, even at other destinations. The moon is actually the hardest destination to predict because of the vacuum of space that our engine is firing into. The plume expands very rapidly before it hits the surface, and that's not an easy thing to predict. So we might have even a little easier way at Mars.
Michelle, you're a pretty popular person. Let's see, in this month, Mars 2020, Perseverance is going to be landing with Medley 2, which you did some work, and boy, you're not slowing down, jumping right into this SCALPS project. How do you have time for anything else?
We've always got so many interesting and challenging problems in EDL, it never gets boring.
Well, that's so true, Michelle, and we really appreciate the work you're doing, but we also appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule to come on the show. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Anytime, Blair, always a pleasure.
You're watching NASA Edge, an inside and outside look at all things NASA.